We've discussed the possibilities and potential of marketing automation, and we hope you're excited to dive in. Let's start with the basics, the anatomy of an automation. As with any process, we have to start. But how? Marketing automation relies on start triggers, actions that trigger the beginning of an automation. For any and every type of automation, you can imagine a different set of circumstances that starts a contact on their journey. A few simple starts include subscribing to a newsletter, filling out the information on a landing page, requesting a demo. These are times when the contact comes to you, requesting something from your business and showing interest. It's important to capture these leads immediately, because even if they don't buy today, they may buy later. These starts help you react. You can use automation to react to that request for information or a demo. Other starts are created to listen. For example, a contact opens an email you send, or a contact visits a page on your website, a landing page, or one of your affiliated social media pages. They may not be asking for anything at the time, but they are engaging with your content. This might be the time to start a campaign that's responsive to their interests and their actions. There are many places to start an automation, just as there are many paths one contact can take on a customer journey. Thinking through what actions your contacts take and what actions you want them to take will help you determine your start. Now you know what your contacts are up to. They've given you a reason to start an automation. So what path would you like them to take? That's where action comes in. For the contact that requested updates, what do they want to be updated about? An automation can help you clarify their interests by asking for additional feedback or information, or by sending them links to products and seeing how they engage. You can watch their interactions with your marketing materials, gather information about what they're interested in, and craft a more personalized outreach in the future. Your contacts are likely engaged at different levels. You can create automations that sort them based on the actions they're taking, tag them appropriately, and follow up with the right information at the right time. These internal sorting actions allow you to automate not just what you send, but how and to whom. They also help you sort your audience and test what they respond to. The final piece of an automation is pretty straightforward. Stop. Marketing automation allows you to craft a customized journey for all of your contacts. Many connected automations that each serve their own purpose or action are best. So all automations should have an endpoint, even if that endpoint moves them along to another automation. Here's an example of a straightforward contact journey. A contact starts by signing up for your emails. They read about your products and click on a link to learn more. You track their views on your webpage. They visit a few products, but keep coming back to the same category. You follow their actions and prepare to take some actions of your own. You send them emails about that category. You were listening after all. A perfectly timed incentive hits their inbox. They decide they're ready to pull the trigger. They buy. At that point, you'll want any automations that they are in that nurtures non-customers to stop. They're a customer now, and you'll want to interact with them in a different way. It's time for a new automation and next steps. They're a customer, and you'd like to capture a review. So now they start in a new automation with the action to capture their online review, and that automation will stop once they do so. Throughout these courses, we'll give you the opportunity to put your learning into action by building, creating, or sharing something that will work best for your business. When building an automation comprised of a start, action, and stop, the possibilities are endless. Or at least they number high enough that we aren't going to do the math. Anyway, to review, start. A start trigger will begin your automation. Action. These are the steps you want your contact, or you, to take within an automation. Lastly, stop. You'll designate an endpoint to that journey. It may lead to another automation, but a stop will help you clarify your process. Next up, a tour of the automation builder. We'll take all of our foundational information of marketing automation and see how the platform works to make your plans a reality. See you in the next video.